please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, which this evening will be led by Scout Chris Birch. Chris, you want to come to the front?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call, please, Mrs. Meltzer.
I'd like to just announce that Dean Reynolds is the president of the Clinton Dell Education Fund, and he has to give a presentation tonight at the school board meeting, but he will be in after that if he makes it in time. So he's excused. Mr. Gilliam?
Here.
Mr. Pearl?
Here.
Mr. Cannon?
Here.
Mrs. West?
Here.
Mr. Sowerby?
Here.
Mrs. Meltzer, here.
Okay, do we have additions and or deletions to tonight's agenda?
Yes, we do. Okay. We are going to postpone item number 12, which is request approval of waiver for trim cut, postponing to the next scheduled meeting.
We would take action, if I can. We would make that motion.
Oh, you had said that. You wanted.
So we leave it on. We'll just make that motion.
Okay. All right. We have add-ons. Number 15, request permission for out-of-state travel, laser fiche and power conference. Number 16, request budget amendment, clerk's office, education and training. 17, request approval for emergency repair of sanitary sewer. Item 18, request approval for the cancellation of December 28th, 2015 Board of Trustees meeting. Item number 19, recommend approval of the relocation of Precinct 3 from Clintondale Middle School at 35300 Little Mac to Clintondale High School, 35200 Little Mac, and also an additional approval of a staff person for firefighters.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gilliam?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Good. Well, thank you for coming to your Township Board meeting this evening. If there's anything you wish to talk about that's on the agenda as it comes before the board, please come to the podium and clearly give us your name and address for the record. If there's something you'd like to talk about that's not on the agenda, please look to the front of the room to your left, and there are public comment cards. Grab one of those and fill it out, and we'll be glad to hear what you have to say at the end of the meeting. And with that, we'll take item number one, recognition of 25-year employees.
At a regular meeting of the Clinton Township Board of Trustees held on December 14, 2015, the following resolution was officially adopted as a permanent record of the Charter Township of Clinton. Whereas Clinton Township has experienced substantial growth in population over the preceding 25 years, during which period certain employees of the township have rendered continuous service. And whereas the Clinton Township Board has recognized that the progress and development of the community and operation of its government in an efficient and effective manner is, in measurable degree, attributable to the diligent and faithful service of all its township employees, but that special recognition is due to those who have now labored in such creditable manner for the past 25 years. And whereas the Clinton Township Board deems it appropriate that special recognition and commendation of each of those employees achieving 25 years of service be here given and made a part of the permanent record of this community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Charter Township of Clinton Board of Trustees, for and on behalf of itself and each of the residents of the township, hereby extends its special recognition and commendation to each of those employees of the township recently achieving 25 years of public service. And the name of the title of the persons are David Popovich from the Building Department, James Gabrish from Department of Public Services, Michael Scott from the Department of Public Services, Jeffrey Fecto from Fire, Ronald Young from Fire, Daniel Allen from Police, Daniel Doering from Police, Kevin Froboda from Police, David Gatz from Police, Walter Jean Jankowski from Police, and Stephen Repkus from Police.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Meltzer. I know, Jeff, you're here. You want to come up and get your certificate? Is there anyone else here that was on the list? This is a perfect example of an employee that we've had for 25 years who's done everything right. Started at the very bottom from day one when he got sworn in. He was being evaluated to become the deputy fire chief. So we're very proud about that, and we're glad you're still with us. And many more years of success. And
thank you for being here.
No, she
and Doran's mother, sir.
We will take Dan. Also, a longtime employee that we're very proud of. Would you like to say anything on behalf of your son?
He's not retiring.
He's not retiring. And by the way, we're glad of that. So thank you. Thank you for sharing him with us.
A motion is ordered.
So moved.
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes, motion passes.
Item two on the agenda. Our retiring employees.
And this is our retirement resolution. At a regular meeting of the Clinton Township Board of Trustees held on December 14th, 2015, the following resolution was officially adopted as a permanent record of the Charter Township of Clinton. Whereas the Clinton Township Board of Trustees finds it an honor and a privilege to extend official recognition and commendation to Eileen Danis, who retired from her position as Assistant Assessor in the Clinton Township Assessing Department for the Charter Township of Clinton on September 16th, 2015. And whereas Eileen Danis began her employment with the Clinton Township Assessing Department as an Appraisal Clerk 1 on August 2nd, 1993, and was promoted to Appraisal Clerk 2 on July 25th, 1995. And whereas Eileen Danis was promoted from Appraisal Clerk 2 to Assistant Office Manager on May 18th, 1998, and within a year was promoted from Assistant Office Manager to Office Manager 2 on May 3rd, 1999, and whereas Eileen Danis was promoted from Office Manager 2 to Property Appraiser 1 on January 30th, 2001, and was promoted from Property Appraiser 1 to Property Appraiser 3 on July 8th, 2002. And whereas Eileen Danis was promoted from Property Appraiser 3 to Senior Property Appraiser on September 26, 2005, and was promoted from Senior Property Appraiser to Assistant Assessor on June 4th, 2013, now therefore be it resolved that the Charter Township of Clinton Board of Trustees for itself and on behalf of the residents of the Charter Township of Clinton hereby commends Eileen Danis for her long and dedicated public service and extends best wishes to her for many healthy and happy retirement years.
Again, Eileen Danis is a perfect example of an employee who started at the bottom and worked her way all the way up to an assistant department head. Took classes along the way. We were very proud of her. She had a wonderful career here. We have other retirees. I don't think we have any other retirees here tonight, do we? In the audience?
Okay. So can I'll just read their names and
read
then.
Read the names.
Okay.
And then we'll say a few words.
All right. Mr. Richard Amarino from DPS, Robert Miller from DPS, John Shea from Fire, Ronald Young from Fire, Diane Stevens, HR, Daniel Allen from Police, William Bryan from Police, Thomas Fournier from Police, Kevin Froboda from Police, David Gatz from Police, Walter Jean Jankowski from Police, and Roger Rosbeck from Police.
Again, names that all of us on the board and other staff members recognize as being some of our superstars. Again, we're pleased to have had them here all these years. We wish them the best in retirement, and we do have certificates for them. And Elizabeth will make sure that everyone gets everything that they should be getting. So with that, we'll thank them, and the floor is open for a motion.
So moved to
support.
The moved and supported. Roll call, please.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Item three. Request approval to purchase 6 Dell laptop computers for field inspectors.
Dear board members, the building department requests your consideration and approval for purchase of 6 Dell rugged laptop computers to help with code enforcement in the field. The total cost of the computers is $12,255.60. Cost is provided through IT. This cost is a budgeted item through capital outlay and is lower than was originally budgeted by $2,595. The laptops are adequate for code enforcement, record keeping, complaint investigations, past history and inspections at construction sites, floodplain areas, and owner identification in the field. It provides the inspectors the information in the field necessary to be more efficient in their work, as well as having the most up-to-date permit and owner taxpayer information. IT has worked hard to get one computer into the field, and we have tested it for the past couple months. Your consideration of this request is appreciated. Sincerely, Barry Miller, Superintendent, Building Department.
Thank you. And Mr. Miller, I'm pleased that you've taken your department into the century they belong.
as far as the technology. So thank you. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Sowerby, supported by?
Support.
Mr. Pearl. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Mouser, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item four is appointment to the DDA or Downtown Development Authority.
Dear board members, three terms are up for reappointment on the Downtown Development Authority. These appointments fall under the jurisdiction of the Township Supervisor with approval by the Township Board. Pat Moran, Andrea Rafus, and James Johnson have expressed interest in being reappointed. These are four-year terms expiring on January 5th, 2020. An application was also received from Lynn Lavoie, which was previously sent to you for your review. It would be appropriate for the board to make the appointment at this time. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller, Administrative Aide.
Thank you, and I am bringing forward Mr. Pat Moran, Mr. James Johnson, and Ms. Lynn Lavoie as my recommendation for appointment.
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Mouser, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item five, appointment to the Zoning Board of Appeals.
Dear board members, there are three terms on the Zoning Board of Appeals up for reappointment. The openings were advertised in accordance to the board policy on committee commission appointments. Ernest Hornung, Frank Morella, and Denise Trombley have expressed interest in being reappointed for another three-year term to expire December 31st, 2018. An application has been received from Carolyn Noble, which was sent to all board members previously for review. It would be appropriate for the board to make the necessary appointments at this time. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller, Administrative Aide.
Thank you. Mr. Hornung, Mr. Morella, and Ms. Trombley have all been very good members of this committee, and I am making a motion to reappoint them.
Mr. Board. Since this is the ZBA, a board appointment, shouldn't we appoint each one individually?
We can do that.
Okay.
Then I will ask Mr. Gillingham for your three choices.
Hornung, Morella, and Trombley.
Thank you.
Mr. Pearl?
Hornung, Morella, Trombley.
Mine are the same. Mrs. West?
Hornung, Morella, and Trombley.
Yep. Mr. Sowerby?
Hornung, Morella, Trombley.
And Mrs. Meltzer?
Hornung, Morella, and Trombley.
Then I'll be glad to make the motion to appoint Mr. Hornung, Mr. Morella, Ms. Trombley.
Support.
Supported by Mr. Pearl.
Oh.
I said it quietly.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And then item six is appointment to the Building Committee.
Dear board members, the terms for the Township's Building Committee are appointed by the board on a yearly basis. Therefore, it would be appropriate to entertain a motion to reappoint Robert Cannon, Kim Meltzer, Barry Miller, Donna Loretti, Carlos Santilla, Mary Bednar, and Debbie Stoller for another year with the terms to expire December 31st, 2016. Thank you for your attention to this matter. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller.
Okay, this is an internal appointment. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item seven is appointment to the Heritage Estate Subcommittee.
Dear board members, the terms for the Township's Heritage Estate Subcommittee need to be reappointed by the board for another year term to expire on December 31st, 2016. The committee currently consists of board members Ken Pearl and Dean Reynolds. Staff members are the Assistant Finance Director, the Public Services Director, the Public Works Assistant Superintendent, the Senior Center Director, and the Administrative Aide. Advisory members are representatives from the management firm Formidable Management Company. It would be appropriate at this time to make the necessary appointments for another one-year term. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller.
Thank you.
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Item eight, appointment to the Personnel Vacancy Committee.
Dear board members, the terms of the Township's Personnel Vacancy Review Committee are appointed on a yearly basis. The current terms expire December 31st, 2015. The committee consists of Township Supervisor, the Township Clerk, Joey West, representing the trustees, the Finance Director, and the Human Resources Director. The alternate member is Trustee Dean Reynolds. It would be appropriate for the board to reappoint the committee as it sees fit. Thank you for your attention to this matter. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller, Administrative Aide.
Thank you. Again, an internal appointment.
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Item 9, appointment to the Refuse Disposal Committee.
Dear board members, the terms for the Township's Refuse Committee are appointed by the board on a yearly basis. The committee currently consists of Kim Meltzer, William Sowerby, Joey West, Donna Loretti, and Brian Gerard. Ex officio members are the Township Administrative Aide and the Township Attorney. It would be appropriate to make the necessary appointments to the committee for another year with the terms to expire December 31st, 2016. Thank you for your attention to this matter. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller, Administrative Aide.
Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Support.
Supported by Mr. Pearl. Roll call, please.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 10 is appointment to the Sanitary Sewer Subcommittee.
Dear board members, the terms for the Township Sanitary Sewer Subcommittee are appointed by the board on a yearly basis. The committee currently consists of Ken Pearl, Robert Cannon, and Kim Meltzer. Staff members are the Finance Director, Assistant, the Public Services Director, the Water and Water Assistant Superintendent, and the Administrative Aide. Consultants are representatives from our engineering firm, Giffels Webster, and Township Attorney Jack Dolan. It would be appropriate to make the necessary appointments to the committee for another year with the terms to expire December 31st, 2016. Thank you for your attention to this matter. Sincerely, Debbie Stoller, Administrative Aide.
So moved.
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 11, approval of revision to the Retiree Healthcare Trust. Well, this is a very extensive letter. Did you want to read it or did you want to just summarize it?
Well, I'd like to read it because okay. It is
all right.
It is a necessary change. Okay. I'll try and read fast. This memorandum is provided to request revisions to the Clinton Township Retiree Healthcare Trust that the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Clinton Retiree Healthcare Trust views as necessary for the continued administration of the trust and for consistency throughout the trust. The section in question is Section 1-204, titled Trustees Term of Office. As Section 1-204 currently reads, the General Employee Representative serves as a two-year term while all other trustees serves for the identical term of office as their elected positions, if applicable, and if not, so long as he or she holds the appropriate position. The Fire and Police Employee Representatives serve a four-year term concurrent with their terms on the Board of Trustees of the Clinton Township Police and Fire Retirement System. The Board of Trustees of the RHC Trust hereby recommends that Section 1-204 be revised to clarify that the General Employee Representative also serve a four-year term which shall begin upon the termination of the general employee's most recently elected term of office. Therefore, please consider the following revisions to Section 1-204 of the RHC Trust as noted in bold underlined italics. So it does go on to read in that section, the term of office will go from 2 years to 4 years. And then in Section 3, a vacancy shall occur if a trustee leaves the employ of the township for any reason, including voluntary or involuntary termination, resignation, retirement, or death. If there is a vacancy in the office of trustee and that trustee office is an elected position and there are more than 6 months remaining in the trustee's applicable term of office, then a special election shall be held for the remainder of that term only. The Board of Trustees of the RHC Trust recommends these proposed revisions to the RHC Trust and further recommends formal action by the Township Board of Trustees to adopt these revisions.
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Item 12 is request approval for a waiver from trim cut.
Bill, did you want to speak to that? No. Okay. We want to make a recommendation to postpone this to the next scheduled meeting.
Is there a motion to that effect?
I'll second that if that's a motion.
Yep.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you. Request to attend Michigan Association of Chiefs of Police Winter Conference from February 3rd through 5th, submitted by our Police Chief.
Dear Board members, I'm requesting Board approval to attend the annual in-state 2016 Michigan Association of Chiefs of Police Professional Development Conference held in Grand Rapids, Michigan, February 3rd to the 5th, 2016. This is budgeted training. Thank you for your prompt consideration in this matter. Sincerely, Fred Pacifist, Chief of Police.
Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gilliam?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Item 14, adoption of ordinance number 419, revision to 1022.03, maintenance of sidewalks and related penalty fees.
Township, what a...
Mr. Dolan, you wanted to summarize, please?
Okay, previously at the most recent board meeting, this was introduced and published with the intent to you consider taking action on this. This is a revision to the sidewalk ordinance. What it does is it establishes what we believe are workable fees for the township to charge in the event that sidewalks aren't timely shoveled and the snow and ice removed. It also establishes a new set of criteria under which responsibility exists for sidewalks. If in fact a home, for example, faces a local street that has a sidewalk, but also perhaps in the rear yard backs up to a mile road that has a sidewalk, responsibility would only exist for the sidewalk abutting the local street as opposed to the mile road. So it's a clarification of some legal points and the establishment of some fees that were done in conjunction with recommendations from the building official and also the director of the Department of Public Services.
Thank you. Mrs. Bednar, who is head of the Department of Public Services, would you tell us how long residents and businesses have to remove snow after a snowfall?
24 hours. That's 24 in here.
It's 24 hours from when the snow stops falling. So if you do have a continuous, like, longer storm, but it's 24 hours from when the snow stops falling.
Thank you. Okay, the floor is open for a motion.
So moved.
Support.
This is the final hearing for it.
Yes.
Right? Okay. So moved for approval.
Support.
It's been nice that the snow has held off so that we didn't have to worry about it. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gilliam?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 15 is request permission for out-of-state travel, Laserfish Empower Conference.
Dear Honorable Board members, I'm requesting your approval to send Jennifer Baranski, Records Manager, and Stephanie Chung, Senior Staff Secretary, to the January 11th, 2015 Laserfish Empower Conference. Along with General Code, we are presently implementing the Laserfish Electronic Content Management Software approved by this board on July 27th, 2015. As a result of our purchase, Laserfish is offering to sponsor two free registrations, and taking advantage of this offer is a $2,400 savings. This conference comes highly recommended and is hosted only in California. I appreciate your support on this matter. Sincerely, Kim Meltzer, Clinton Township Clerk. And if I can speak to that?
Yes.
So we just finished our implementation with our Laserfish software. So we're really excited about that. And as a result, we had to go through some training on writing templates and workflow. It's very computer intensive, and as a result, there is some training that needs to, you know, that the staff needs to learn. There's two approaches we could take. We could outsource and have these workflows and templates put in place. But based on the recommendation of the person that put in that implemented the software, and after working with two of my employees in the clerk's office, our records manager Jennifer Baranski and Stephanie Chung, who is close to her finishing her degree in computer science, his recommendation that we would get a benefit from sending those two, and as a result would hopefully make it so that we do not have to outsource. So right now, as statistically as it works, is about 1% only of anybody in the records management industry is able to implement workflows and templates. And I want to be one of that 1%. I want that for Clinton Township because it will save us money. So the total cost for this conference is $3,703.64 for two. And as I said, at this time, this is a $2,400 savings because the $1,200 per registration fee is being waived for both of them.
Thank you. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Is there a second? Second. Roll call, please.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Gillaham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 16 is a continuation of this, requesting a budget amendment for this training.
I'm requesting your approval to amend my 2015-16 budget to reflect an increase in the amount of $3,703.64 to pay for education costs associated with the implementation of the new electronic content management software, Laserfiche. The dollars will be used to pay for all costs associated with sending two employees from the clerk's office in the 2016 Laserfiche Empower Conference hosted in Long Beach, California. Thank you for your attention to my request. Sincerely, Kim Meltzer, Clerk.
Thank you. Is there a motion to approve?
Can I ask a quick question?
Sure.
Why is the airfare $1,011 when it says right here it's 381 round trip?
It's not here. This is for two people, and
right, that yeah. comes out to be 700 and something.
It's not right. That's a typo.
That's a typo?
Yeah, it's
it should be 581 or whatever.
It would be.
I guess a question I would ask on the budget amendment, because these are estimated costs, if we should just go up to 3,800 instead of 3,703.64, just to cover your possibility of.
We already have, I mean, these are exact costs, but.
And, well, you have estimated down on, you know, dinner and some other things. I'm just a question. It's, you know, just so you're not coming back and going, why was I another $8 over or anything like that. It's just my thought.
Well, I appreciate that.
I mean, I just, you know.
You can make that a motion.
I'll make a motion to increase your budget or make a budget amendment of $3,800 to include the cost of this event.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
I do just real quick want to address a point, and that is, as we spoke about this during the last agenda item, you had mentioned, Ms. Meltzer, that only 1% of the companies actually write these workflow studies, and you're hoping that we can do that, and ultimately this is an investment that we're making into hopefully not having to contract out and therefore a cost savings. Mm-hmm. Am I understanding that correctly?
Yes.
Okay. And so when, like, for instance, when we bought this software, when did we anticipate getting to the point where we would be putting together workflows and making the decision to contract or do it in-house and, you know, expelling these, or rather incurring these expenses?
Well, this is, I mean, we knew that there would be costs associated with the implementation of the right. software. We weren't exactly sure what those costs would be.
Right.
And I'm always looking at ways to mitigate costs. Yep. There could be an exponentially high cost if we had to outsource. Yep. So I'd rather us attempt, and based on the implementation, the director that put in the implementation of the software, right. he was very confident that we have an incredible IT department. Mm-hmm. I know you and all of us know that. Yep. He was very impressed with it. And he said, as a result, with our IT department and with the women that I have in the clerk's office right now, that we should be able to do the workflows and the templates ourselves, saving the township a lot of money.
Yeah. But my point is, and this is like, at what point do we budget for workflows? So we won't be budgeting for workflows. From this point, it'll be a part of sort of the normal course of doing business during the day, and that'll be that work, instead of contracting for it, will be a normal part of those employees' salaries and their work responsibilities. So there's no additional budgeted items for workflows?
Not at this time.
At least that we'd anticipate.
Right, not okay. at this time.
Okay. Because we're amending the budget here. Yeah. And so.
And I did hem and haw.
When we did this, did we not anticipate. Yeah. the, you know, this sort of like second phase here, the workflow sort of phase, if you will?
Well, we knew there would be additional costs to implement. However, like I said, we didn't know what those were. Okay. And I did, like I said, hem and haw whether or not, because I don't like to go outside the budget. I could have waited until next year, but it just so happens that there's an advantage. Next year, we wouldn't have been offered the free registration.
Yeah.
So, Don Brewer, the person that came in, the specialist that came in to implement it, the software said that he felt that both Jennifer Bransky and Stephanie Chung were very qualified to go in at this time and take advantage of the free registration and learn as much as they can on workflows and templates and bring that back to the township for implementation.
And I just want to be clear here. I'm going along with this, and I believe, you know, we're probably doing the right thing. And but I'm just, you know, in terms of an item, how do we budget for it, and how do we budget for the cost? That's the only sort of thing that I'm questioning. So
next budget, I will budget for this. However, I may budget for this. Let me say that instead of saying I will. Once they come back, I'll ask them in terms of, and we'll all consult with Laserfiche on what more
okay.
training they might need, if any at all.
Okay.
So, and if, you know, I'll try and, if it comes down to the fact that we need to send them again, because it is an extensive, and I'm sending two, so they're not going to be going to the same classes. So I specifically requested that they attend separate classes so we could maximize the amount of education. But that doesn't mean they're going to every class either.
Right.
That's offered. So if there's if there's a need for us to send them back, there would be I would make a budget request for that.
So you'd be making that assessment at the time.
Yeah, it wouldn't be an extension at that point. I'll know. They're only going to be gone for 3 days, so I'll know. Or is it 4 days? 4 days, I think it is. I'll know when they come back. We'll do an assessment of what they've learned and what we need to anticipate, if anything, for the following year budget.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I appreciate taking up some time with us.
You're welcome.
We have a motion and a support?
We do.
Roll call, please.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Yeah, I'd like to just take a second and thank the Chippewa Valley government students for coming out this evening. I can assure you, I don't remember any meeting all year where we all voted the same way on every item. So this is a different kind of a board meeting. Oftentimes we have lively, spirited, enthusiastic debates. So this is highly unusual. But we're glad about it. Okay, thank you. Item 17, request approval for emergency repair of sanitary sewer.
Dear board members, the Zone 6 Sanitary Sewer Point Repairs Project was awarded to DVM Utilities, Inc. on November 2nd, 2015. The work scope of that project was to perform open cut repairs to 9 structurally deficient sewer pipe locations that were identified during the Zone 6 CCTV and sewer cleaning project completed earlier this year. Shortly after the bid award of the Zone 6 sewer repairs, the Water and Sewer Department discovered a break in existing sewer pipe along the frontage of 34250 Grosbeck Avenue. This was observed after routine cleaning and televising of sanitary sewers connected to restaurants in this area. The newly observed broken pipe was not part of the Zone 6 work scope area, but upon further evaluation, it was determined to require an emergency repair. Sediment was beginning to enter the pipe and began creating a depression in the greenbelt frontage of 34250 Grosbeck Highway. An emergency repair was necessary to avoid additional undermining of the soil and nearby pavement. In summary, a 20 lineal foot segment of sewer needed to be replaced, and the sewer must be lined immediately to enhance the structural integrity of the remaining pipe to the upstream terminating manhole. Since DVM Utilities, Inc. is currently under contract to perform similar sewer repair work, the Water and Sewer Department and the Engineering requested they provide the repair services with the condition that the relevant pay items be comparable to other scope items in the current Zone 6 sewer point repair contract. The contractor agreed to these terms. The additional pay items and associated unit prices were reviewed and accepted by Department of Public Services. A more specific summary of the additional scope items with related costs to date is attached with this letter. The total cost is to perform the additional scope of work is $62,664. Please accept the summary outlining the necessity of this additional sewer repair area. And if you have any further questions, please do not hesitate to contact our office for further clarification. Respectfully submitted, Scott Chabot, Senior Project Manager for Giffords Webster.
Thank you. Mr. Chabot is here this evening. If there are any questions of board members?
I just want to make sure I'm understanding this correctly. So we're under these orders from the Department of Environmental Quality that we have to figure out how we get water out of our system. And so we've taken cameras through the sewer lines. And because of that project, because we're under orders to do that, we identified this weakness in the line, and we're now realizing, okay, yeah, since we found it, we better fix it now.
Actually, not quite.
Okay, all right.
Last month, you approved a project to fix 9 that we did do TV and cleaning last year and found error. This one we stumbled across. It was not part of that initial project. However, because of the severity of it and so forth, we thought it was important to get it done immediately since we found it and need to take care of it. So what we're asking is to change the scope of this contract to include this. And we've done this in the past, but don't necessarily always, didn't always come to the board. So as part of being transparent, we wanted to bring it to the board to say, hey, this contractor's already been approved for this amount. It's not a change order, because it's a change order is something where, oh, we didn't realize we needed X, or we needed a little bit more of this. This is a complete add.
This is an additional scope of work.
Right. So this is a change of scope. So this is just to bring to the board saying, hey, we found this emergency, and we'd like this contractor who is already under contract with us to take care of this project or this problem.
And we're probably saving money by doing it now.
Yes. In fact, we did competitively bid similar projects, and that's what this letter says, and he is holding those contract prices. So if we would have known about it, we would have included it, you know, a month and a half ago, but at this point it's being included.
Okay, great, thank you.
Further questions?
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second? Any questions from the community? Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Gilliam?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 18 is a request approval for the cancellation of the December 28th, 2015 meeting, which is a very common practice. I would also like to include in that we authorize our treasurer and our finance department to pay any necessary bills prior to board approval should they deem it necessary in that time period. So that'll be my motion.
Support.
Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gilliam?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item 19, recommend approval of the relocation of Precinct 3 from Clintondale Middle School to Clintondale High School.
In accordance with Michigan Election Law, MCL 168.662, the Election Commission of the Charter Township of Clinton is requesting approval to move the location of Precinct 3 from Clintondale Middle School to Clintondale High School, effective with the March 8th, 2016 presidential primary election. Sincerely, Kim Meltzer, Clinton Township Clerk.
Thank you.
And Secretary for the Clinton Township Election Commission. Sorry. So, can I go ahead and explain that a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Precincts 7 and 11 are at the high school, and we just met Paul Gilliam and Ken Pearl and myself make up the election commission. And so, as I stated, by election law, we have to approve this and then come to the board for approval on anytime there's a movement or deletion of any precincts. So in this case, we're requesting per Clintondale High School, they've asked us to look into this, and both myself, Kim Irvine, my deputy, Mike Scott from DPW, and then also the director of operations at Clintondale High School, Laura, I can't remember her last name right now, we all met and went over that, and we all agree that we should combine that or move that precinct to the high school. It's a bigger area in which to do it, and it's in preparation Not only, well, because of the presidential election that's going to be coming up in November, we decided to do it in March, and then, so we'll have the March election and then the August election, so that people are used to going to those precincts, even though those are smaller turnouts. So by the time the presidential election happens in November, the public should be pretty comfortable with the move.
Thank you. Mrs. West?
No, she answered everything I was looking for.
And it's actually closer for the neighborhood to go there.
It's a few feet closer.
About 200 yards.
Yeah.
It just makes sense because the other location, Precinct 3, was a much smaller area. And so this widens it, opens it up a lot more, and we'll be able to receive a bigger crowd.
Very good. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Sowerby, supported by Mr. Pearl. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And we added on a staff position for the fire department due to the length of the timing of our next board meeting.
This is an additional staff person for the fire department by the name of Blake Siebert. Oh, okay. The fire department has processed one candidate for entry-level position as a firefighter medic for a vacancy within that rank. A conditional offer of employment has been made to this individual, and it is my desire to hire Blake Siebert to begin employment on January 4th, 2016. Mr. Siebert possesses all the required certifications, has passed all background checks, and he has completed his medical evaluations. This is a budgeted position. Blake will begin his one-year probationary period of firefighter at the entry wage of $42,912, which includes the contractual stipend for being a paramedic. Thank you for your continued support. Michael Fye, Chief of Fire.
So moved.
Thank you.
Support.
Moved and supported. Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Approval of the minutes of the November 30th, 2015 regular Township Board meeting.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Approval of the bills?
So moved.
Without objection. Is there a second?
Second.
I'll second it. Roll call, please.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. There are no public comments. Our next Township Board meeting will be on January 11th, 2016. Thank you very much for your attendance this evening. Motion to adjourn is in order.
So moved.
Happy holidays.
Yep. Motion by Mr. Pearl. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Mrs. West. Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Meeting adjourned.